Hey you guys, it's Yophi here, coming to you from an empty classroom, but normally this is where I would teach. But I did want to come to you with the thought that I hope would encourage you as far as your fears and how to respond to them. See, the New Testament is a great way to find out who we really are when we get born again in Christ. The world responds to things a certain way. And when you respond like Jesus, you will get a few different responses from them, but their response does not determine how you are to continue to act, how you are continue to think. So I love to go to the example of Jesus and the examples of the apostles and converts as good ways to relate to today. So, you know, there's obviously this pandemic going on, which I have already prophesied by the time that somebody else watches this video next year, this will be an afterthought, okay? It won't be this is still going on, we're all dead. No, that's not going to happen. This is not going to take us out. But to show you this, I wanted to give an example in the Gospels, and then I wanted to give another example in Acts. If you go to the Gospels, Mark chapter 4, the disciples decided to cross the sea, and on it there arose a storm. So the wind was blowing, the waves are crashing up against the boat, you know, they're having a difficult time. And Jesus was asleep. So this response, you know, God will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies type. You are completely relaxed. Everyone around you is panicking. Jesus is sleeping while everyone else is panicking because he already knows that he has a destination. He has a destiny. There's no point in trying to panic when you have not done what you have set out to do yet. So a lot of people don't know their destiny, and that's why they're panicking now. A lot of people don't know that they even have a purpose, right? You talk to them about God and about how there's a purpose for their life, and they don't have one because the world doesn't tell them that. The world tells them that there's no point in living. The world tells them that when you die, you're just going to go back to the dirt. That's it. There's no God. There's no hope. There's no nothing. Well, when a pandemic like this hits, they're going to panic because they have no purpose. They have no destiny. Okay? Their destiny is just to live sensually, fulfill every lustful, natural desire, and then die. Right? That's why they can't put down their phones. You can't put down the TV. You can't put down the video games. You can't put down the food. There's excess, you know, overweight because people just can't stop eating junk food and such. You tell them about fasting, there's no point. Even Christians, you know, there's no point to it. So there's a crisis in that. That's the real crisis. The real crisis is not necessarily a virus. It's the fact that there's no hope. Jesus had hope, which is why he could go to sleep when others were panicking. Look at what the disciples said. You go to Mark 4 and read it. They're telling him, they woke him up and said, Master, don't you care that we're dying? Don't you care? These are the types of things that people will say when you refuse to give in to the fear that they have. Don't you care? If you cared, you would be doing what we're doing when Jesus was just sleeping. You see, they were upset with him, but that's what fear does. Fear will cause you to get angry and upset with people for not fearing. You see? So don't get upset. This is a time to hope. And when you hope, yes, you might get a certain response, just like Jesus did with the disciples here. But Jesus got up. What was his response? He spoke to the wind and the waves. He rebuked them. He didn't argue with the disciples. He rebuked the wind and the waves and told them to stop. And then when the wind and the waves ceased, Then all of a sudden, instead of them being fearful of the wind and the waves, they became fearful of what Jesus could do. And they were awestruck. They were amazed. What kind of man is this? They weren't asking it, they were saying it. What kind of man is this that even the wind and the waves obey him? This is what people should be saying about you. What kind of man or what kind of woman is this that even the coronavirus does not have any effect on them? As a matter of fact, they could speak to coronavirus and it has to leave. They could speak to paralysis and it has to leave. This is the kind of testimony that we should have. And if you don't have that, then today's a good opportunity. You pray, you speak the words of life. And with thanksgiving, we understand that God will do what we ask. So that was an example, but I also wanted to bring you to Acts. In Acts, by this time, the disciples were apostles, right? So they had graduated, okay? And Peter's put in prison, okay? He was put in jail. So Herod wanted to kill him. He had already killed James, right? So Herod's going to kill Peter now. But he had to wait because he couldn't kill him until after the Easter. I know that that's not a word. I understand that. We'll get on the holidays later. So he wanted to kill Peter, but he had to wait. So Peter's in jail, and this is Acts chapter 12, and it said that he was sleeping. Now, this same Peter, who was panicking on the boat from wind and waves, now he's got a death sentence. Herod's going to kill him the very next morning, and he's sleeping. He had not a care in the world. He was basically on the Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego deal. My God's going to save me, but I tell you what, even if he doesn't save me, I'm still not going to bow down to fear. I'm not going to bow down to your gods. And the fear, the spirit of fear, is the God that is trying to run rampant in this country, in this world. People are afraid to look at each other. People are afraid to touch each other. People are just, it's a panic. It's the same thing that the disciples were under. And it's the same thing that the devil expected Peter to be under. He expected Peter to be up biting his nails, sleepless nights. He can't sleep. But tell you what, Peter was asleep between two guards in chains. An angel broke Peter out of jail. But what was amazing is that it says, go to Acts chapter 12, it'll say that the angel smote him, which means the angel had to hit him to wake him up. Isn't that amazing? That Peter is ready to be put to death and he's just chilling. Hey, I needed a nap. So he's sleeping. He was that confident that either he was going to be with the Lord or I'm getting out of here. You see, the other people were praying for him like they should have, and then God did his job. All throughout the Bible, you will see that there is a spirit of fear. And the difference between a believer and a non-believer is that spirit of fear grabs the non-believer and causes them to act in herd behavior. Okay, now I'm not condemning anyone. What I am saying is that you will see that the people of God were in a different category. They did not submit to fear. Peter submitted to fear when those people asked him, when Jesus, are you one of his disciples? He said, no, I don't know him. He denied Jesus three times in one night. And then afterwards, the disciples were cowering in fear. It was the women who went to go check up on Jesus, on his body. So they were in fear. But then the Spirit of God took a hold of them. They prayed, asked for boldness. And ever since that time, they counted it. They were thankful to even get beaten or imprisoned or anything for the gospel's sake. All right, they counted all joy when they fell into diverse temptations. All right, so I want to encourage you that this fear that seems to be sweeping the nation doesn't have to be you. You don't have to submit to any virus, to any disease. You don't have to submit to it. Was Jesus careless? No. But did they think he was careless? Yes, because he was sleeping, because he was calm, because he was collected, because he wasn't helping. But God's method of help is always different from the world's method. So I encourage you, keep the faith. You do not have a spirit of fear, but you have a spirit of power, of love, and of a sound mind. And this thing will die. I declare it. It will die, and we will continue to be who we are. As a matter of fact, God is going to do things differently. Several companies and things, they're going to fall off. But the people of God are going to rise up in a way like never before. And that's you. So you be encouraged today. You be blessed. You stay in your word, and we stay fearless. All right? Peace, guys.